are going to read a story from the story tree. Tales to Read Aloud, retold by Hugh Lumpton, illustrated by Sophie Fazos. This story is called The Little Red Hen, and it is an English story. Once upon a time, there was a plump little red hen, and she was scratching and scratching with her feet in the dust. Suddenly, she found a grain of yellow wheat. "Tut, tut, this wheat should be planted," she thought. "Who would help me plant this grain of wheat in the soft soil?" "Not I," said Dab the duck. "Not I," said Tib the cat. "Not I," said Tod the fox. "Well then, I'll plant it myself," said the little red hen, and she did. Soon enough, the grain had grown to a tall stalk with a long ear of yellow wheat at the top of it.
Let me show it.
Tut tut, this wheat is ripe. Wheat is ripe. She clucked. "Who will help me cut it?" "Not I," said Dab the duck. "Not I," said Tib the cat. "Not I," said Tod the fox. "Well then, I'll cut it myself," said the little red hen, and she did. Soon enough, the ear of yellow was lying at her feet. "Tut, tut, this ear is ready for threshing," she clucked. "Who will help me thresh it?" "Not I," said Dab the duck. "Not I," said Tib the cat. "Not I," said Tod the fox. "Well then, I'll thresh it myself," said the little red hen. And she did. Soon enough, the wheat was threshed, and she'd blown away all the chaff with the flapping of her wings. "Tut, tut, this wheat is ready for milling," she clucked. "Who will help me mill it into flour?" "Not I," said Dab the duck. "Not I," said Tim the cat. "Not I," said Tod the fox. "Well then, I'll mill it myself," said the little red hen, and she did. Soon enough, the wheat had been milled between the two stones into fine, soft flour. "Tut, tut, this flour is ready for baking," she clucked. "Who will help me bake it into bread?" "Not I," said Dab the duck. "Not I," said Tib the cat. "Not I," said Tod the fox. "Well then, I'll bake it myself," said the little red hen.
"Said who?"
said the little red hen. And she did. Soon enough, it was mixed and kneaded and baked into a loaf of sweet, fresh, steaming bread. "Tut, tut, this bread is ready for eating," she clucked. "Who'll help me eat it?" "Not I will," said Dab the duck. "I will," said Tim the cat. "I will," said Tod the fox. "Oh, no, you won't," said the little red hen. "I planted it all by myself. I cut it all by myself. I threshed it and milled it and baked it all by myself. And now I'm going to eat it all by myself." And she did. And that was the end of that story. Bye.